What's up, weirdo? Shadetree Surgeon here, and boy, ain't I a day late and a dollar short with this video. Did you know that Indian released a new motorcycle called the Challenger? Did you know that it has a frame-mounted fairing? And oh God, did you know it makes even more horsepower than the Harley Davidson Road Glide? Stop the presses! Call the police! This just can't be so. A fixed fairing bagger that outperforms the Road Glide?
Inconceivable!
At least that's what seems to be the general attitude of everybody online in the past week. Who you ask, the new Indian Challenger has basically reinvented motorcycles as we know it, and is single-handedly gonna put Harley Davidson out of business, or it's a cheap shot knockoff great value version of the Road Glide. First off, the fact that anybody is shocked that Indian's making a fixed fairing performance bagger is absolutely ridiculous. I'm sorry guys, but do you really think that one, Harley Davidson invented fixed fairing touring bikes, and two, nobody else has ever tried to make a better Road Glide? If you really want to get technical, then everyone, including Harley Davidson, is just really ripping off Craig Vedder's Windjammer fairing. But to me, that's ridiculous. That's like saying that any book that has elves, orcs, and questing in it is a Tolkien ripoff. Taking inspiration from other places does not automatically invalidate a concept, especially when the new concept improves on the original. But putting my love of dragons and wizards aside, has everyone completely forgot that everyone else did the exact same thing that Indian has done? The Honda F6B with about 120 horsepower, 120 foot-pounds of torque, and a fixed fairing. Boy, doesn't that look familiar? Although technically the Honda Goldwing's fixed fairing does predate the Road Glide. And come on, you're gonna call the Indian Challenger a ripoff and not talk about the Yamaha Eluder? Wait a second, should Eluder fans be pissed off at Indian ripping off their ripoff since technically they ripped off the Road Glide first? Oh, and earlier, the reason that I had to put performance bagger in quotation marks is because in a world where the BMW K1600B exists with 160 horsepower, everybody else is just living in its shadow and fighting for scraps. I have personally spent time on a BMW K1600. It will melt your fucking face off. Oh, and speaking of BMWs, guess who else had a fixed fairing on a motorcycle that predates the Road Glide? And I can't not mention the Kawasaki Vaquero, just because on a personal level, I find the Vaquero's fixed fairing to be far and above the best looking one available on a bike being made today. It's a real shame that Kawasaki hasn't kept their engine up to par with everybody else, because when you stack the Vaquero against the competition, as far as the engine goes, it comes up pretty short. When we're talking fast bikes and fixed fairings, a company that has the police model KZ1000 in its history, I expect better. But anyway, back to the Challenger. 122 horsepower, 128 foot-pounds of torque, bunch of camshafts, blah, 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 blah. If you're watching this video, you probably already know all about it. If you just want a robot to read you a spec sheet out loud, go watch somebody else's video. That's what they do. It's not what I do. Personally, I think the Indian Challenger is a great-looking motorcycle. I'm not particularly crazy about that whole Cyclops thing that it has going on up front. The headlight almost looks like it belongs in an F-150 or something. I'm okay with a single headlight. Plenty of bikes with fixed fairings look great with a single headlight, but it's just so wide. It's like Indian wanted the best of both worlds and it just didn't work. Either put two headlights in there or make the whole shebang smaller. That's what I think anyway. As far as styling goes on all these fixed fairing baggers, personally, I would put the Yamaha Eluder and the Kawasaki Vaquero tied for top place. I just personally think that those two bikes look better than the Road Glide and the Challenger, which style-wise for me, those guys are about neck and neck in second place. And unfortunately, I'd put the Beamer and the F6B somewhere in a distant third behind the American boys. But hey, that's just personal preference. Make sure you leave me a comment down below and let me know where you rank all these bikes. But at the end of the day, I'm not really all that interested in the Challenger. It's just not a bike I would buy. What I am interested in is the Challenger's engine. A big inch modern liquid cooled V-twin. This is what I want to see from Indian. To me, the new Power Plus engine is everything that the Thunderstroke isn't. Where the Thunderstroke is just pretending to be something it isn't. It's pretending to be vintage. It's all gaudy flash and these accents that don't do anything. Then you look at the Power Plus, that's an engine that means business. What I personally really hope to see is the new Power Plus engine in a mid-sized bike, somewhere in between a Scout and a Challenger. Same concept as the FXR. Stuff a big inch motor into a smaller frame and let her rip. And finally, to address the actual title of this video, let's talk about why, even though I think the Challenger is an amazing motorcycle, I think it looks good, I think it's gonna be a great bike, despite all that, I still don't think it stands a chance against Harley Davidson. A lot of the pro-Indian comments and arguments that I see is that for the extra money that you pay for the Road Glide, you get all the bells and whistles on the Indian, and in order to make a Road Glide perform as good as we're hoping the Indian Challenger is going to perform, you got to spend enough money that you could buy a whole another motorcycle with it. These are all completely true statements, but far from being why Harley Davidson will fail, these are the reasons why Harley will succeed. An out-of-the-box factory performance bagger is no more going to topple the Road Glide than the Honda Fury is going to stop people from building their own choppers. People want to make their bikes fast. The whole allure of a performance Road Glide is that it's built from a platform that was never meant to perform. Being able to rip a wheelie all the way down the block on a bike that people assume is going to be slow is why people want to do it in the first place. Harley is perfectly aware of this, by the way, and it's the reason why their engineers always leave horsepower in the engine by design for the aftermarket to discover. Let's be honest here, guys. If spec sheets, numbers, facts, and figures were the only thing that mattered when it came to buying a motorcycle, then Harley Davidson would have been out of business a very long time ago. And hey, maybe I'm wrong. Maybe Indian is planning this whole sort of erector set mentality that Harley Davidson uses with making its bikes fast. Maybe that's what they're planning for the Challenger, but it just really doesn't seem that way. They seem to be touting this thing as an out-of-the-box factory performance bagger. And yeah, sure, the Challenger, it'll take some Harley sales away, it'll eat some Road Glide sales, just like the Honda F6B did, and just like the K1600B did. Is it going to replace the Harley-Davidson Road Glide as the premier platform to build a custom performance touring bike on? I sincerely doubt it. Regardless of all that, it's still a very exciting and competitive time in the world of motorcycles right now. And at the end of the day, we are the ones who win from competition. So as far as I'm concerned, I say, bring it on. Excited to see what the Indian Challenger does. All right, guys, if you enjoyed this video, make sure you subscribe and smash that like button for me. Also, make sure you leave me a comment with your thoughts. I love hearing what you guys think. So tell me what you think about the Indian Challenger versus the Harley Davidson Road Glide. And till next time, y'all, keep it weird.